Hey guys, Artistix here. Guess what? Today we're going deep. 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 No, we're not talking about some amazing... I don't know. We're just going to read some poems. I got this book. I don't remember where. I got this book called Dragons Guard the Zoo, and it's a good book. And I got it signed by the author. Do you know how cool that is? Like, meet the author of a book? It was cool. Well, anyways... I like poems. Poetry is cool. Poetry is like writing, only I like writing stories. Stories are my favorite. Well, anyways, I guess I'll read a few poems because we're going deep. Most of the time we'll just be messing around acting weird because I can't go very deep without, like, laughing. Well, let's start off with one of my favorite poems. It's called Untrustworthy. Yeah. That has to explain a lot about my personality, that my favorite poem is called Untrustworthy. Well, anyways, let's begin. I don't have the nerve to tell you the truth. I wish I were more than I am. But I cross my heart and promise to tell you the littlest lie that I can. If you don't get the meaning behind that poem, then just listen to it over and over again until you understand. But anyways, let's continue. Wait, what was that? Oh, contentment. I haven't seen this one. Well, to be fair, I haven't searched through the entire poem. I flipped through it until I saw a picture I liked. Because these poems have pictures. Look at all the illustrations. Well, let's read this one. Contentment. Some butter and bread and my nice old cat. Why would anyone want more than that? That's a nice poem. The author of this book is actually very deep. Oh, what's this? His own. Each has his own. As thee hath my thine. I love my goose because she's mine. Well, that wasn't very deep. So basically the poem was about everyone has their own thing, and I love my goose because it's mine. The Robin and the Bluebell. Well, some of my friends love birds, so I'll read this. They'll probably feel super offended at the end because, I don't know, robins. Come with me, said the robin, I'm sorry, I can't speak. Come with me, the robin said, and fly around a bit. Sorry, said the bluebell, flowers were born to sit. Oh dear, began the little bird, I want to fly around and cross the river, see the sights, not stay here on the ground. That's quite okay, the bluebell said, you go on and don't mind me. Look around and then come back and tell me what you see. Knowing you, you'll bob and weave, flying fast and furious. You'll come back and tell me all, then, and is it not quite, not curious? You'll put your head beneath your wing and sleep too tired to care, while my imagination will then fly me everywhere. Oh, that's a nice one. What's this one? This one doesn't even have a name. Let's read it. Music is not weighed for worth. The smallest of songs is welcome on earth. Well, as you know, I love music. Music. Oh, I love music. Got me through depression. The Pitiful Truth. I don't want to read this one. I just want to... Okay, so if we go back to my favorite poem called Untrustworthy. Look at that mouse. Okay, now, let's go back to the poem I just found. Oh no, did I lose it? I think I lost it. Guys, I think I lost it. I found it. Okay, The Pitiful Truth also has a mouse. Or a rat. Or whatever it is. Well, I guess since I showed you the pictures already, we might as well read it. Sometimes things will happen in a way you never planned. Do not cling to lies and excuses, though you won't be looking grand. This is the time for courage, and there's no more noble stand than to face your accusers with nothing but your pitiful truth in your hand. Well, that's sad. That was sad. Okay, When I forget there's a world out there, and I'm feeling alone and glum, it sends me soft and gentle winds, and then all these little stars come. Oh, that's nice. So basically, he's saying when he's upset, because it's nighttime, there's a bunch of twinkly stars to make him feel better. Okay. The world. The world so wraps around us that all creatures may abide. I am safe and warm within, and the wolf is safe outside. That is a good poem. That is amazing. I would like to say how that is... Oh. This one has another mouse. It's like a mouse with a garden gate. And it has, like, nice little plants everywhere. Okay, go in peace. The saddest pig I'm sorry, guys. I can't speak. Ugh.
Artifix, why don't you go and, like, learn to speak or something?
I'm sorry. I can't do it. Anyways, let's continue. I'm insane.
We can all come to the terms that I'm not right in the mind.
The saddest thing that people say when they reach that final door, I could have been a better person, I could have done more. But don't despair, though you fail today, life starts anew tomorrow. For each whatever light we see is the light that we must follow. Go in peace, there's just one test, rest easy, you've done your best.
Oh, that's nice. Saying, because we all know that when it comes to death, we all say we could have been a better person. The American Pioneer. Let's read this one. This one seems nice.
200 years ago, you walked this land. You walked alone, a stranger. You held a small child by the hand. No one caught you when you fell, or wept up to see you fail. You broke the soil and lifted up the grain, and you left a trail to follow. You shouldered a forest to build a cabin, log by log by log. You had it done by winter, so you made it through the cold. When you lost your corn to summer, and you lost your child to fall, with no place to go for turning back, you stood and took it all. Then another came, and then another, strong like you, then more, to build 1,000 cities where no city stood before. You waked and farmed the valley, you strained and mined the hill. When hope died in your blossom, it hardened into will. You hammered a true nail and drew a straight plan. You flew with the eagle, and you bowed to no man.
That's nice. I think it was talking about a girl, though. Yes. There's another poem. One last poem, guys. Because I know you're getting tired of my speech, because I can't speak. Where is it? It was a really good poem, too. Here, let's check the table of contents like a smart little girl. Okay. Where's T-E? Oh, wait, I think the doesn't count. So let's go to C. So the poem I want to read you guys is called The Coolest Guy, but I need to find the page. Okay, The Coolest Guy, page 55. Well, that was at the very beginning of the book. Found it. Oh. Now, I think we can all relate to this one, unless you are the coolest guy. He has the highest grades in school. All the guys think he's so cool. All the girls think he's extreme. He's captain of the soccer team and usually makes the winning score. He volunteers to help the poor. He looks just like a movie star. He's in a band. He plays guitar. He won the county spelling bee. His father won the lottery. He's known as a computer whiz and always aces every quiz. His birthday party's out of sight. They shoot off fireworks at night. He's brave, there's nothing he won't try, and he couldn't be a nicer guy. He even lets his sister berate him. The perfect guy. I just hate him. Yep, we all know the perfect person, and we all know that it's super annoying. Well, I have something to say to you. Perfection is an illusion, so don't feel bad about yourself. Oh, wait. I'm gonna read one more, because this one's hilarious. I forgot it was here. It's next to The Coolest Guy. So this is the poem on the other side of the page. Okay. When the bough breaks. Rock-a-bye baby on the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. I understand the nursery rhyme. The picture's clear. The words are fine. But what kind of idiots, tell me please, would hang their babies up in trees? It's amazing. It's pure geniusness. What idiots would do that? That's a true question. Well, guys, I want you to answer that question in the comments. What kind of idiots would hang their babies in trees? Tell me. I hope you subscribe. Goodbye!